I will present updated outcome data from the MINDEC trial. And maybe the viewers know that the MINDEC trial was a large prospective randomized trial run in 9 countries in Europe, including the UK, and where we randomized 6,693 patients based on their early diagnosed breast cancer patients, based on their clinical pathological factors combined with the genomic information from their tumor, and that was done by MammaPrint. So my disclosure is that I'm a founder of Agendia that markets MammaPrint, but I think I'm not discussing any off-label use, just to be sure that everybody understands what I'm into this. So the EORTC, the European Organization of Research and Treatment of Cancer, suggested to do this trial, which ran from 2007 to 2011. 6,693 patients were enrolled. If patients had their clinical and genomic risk assessment, patients would either be both low risk, low, low, both high risk, high, high by both assessment, or they could be discordant. So they were genomically high, clinical low, or they were clinical high and genomic low, that's what I just said, or they were clinical high and genomic low. So what the main aim of the trial was to look in the clinical high, genomic low population to see if you would either use your clinical or genomic assessment and based on that would get or would not get chemotherapy if it was safe to forgo chemotherapy. So what we have shown in 2016, and we presented earlier this year at ESCO, that those patients, if you take all patients that are randomized to no chemotherapy, the primary aim of the study shows that their survival is excellent, 95% at 5 years, which indicates that it's safe to de-escalate the chemotherapy to no chemo for that group. So what I'm presenting, and what actually the first part was also presented at ESCO, if you look into a differentiation by age, so for patients diagnosed before age 50 or after 50, which we took as the premenopausal, as postmenopausal status surrogate, then it shows that for patients who are over age 50, if you compare that the group without chemotherapy with the clinical high genomic low who did get chemotherapy, and then the survival difference at 8 years is 0.2%. So there is no gain for postmenopausal women to have chemotherapy. However, in the patient group under 50, we saw that for clinical high genomic low, the comparison between with and without chemotherapy gave a 5% survival difference at 8 years. So that suggests that there is, in the trial as done, a beneficial effect of chemotherapy. However, we also noticed that those patients only received tamoxifen as endocrine treatment, and chemotherapy has an effect that's called that on ovarian suppression. So to shut down all of the estrogen production from the ovaries. And so it is suggested that maybe the chemotherapy effect in this patient group is actually caused by the ovarian suppression effect of chemotherapy. Of course, we were not able to formally prove that because we didn't study that in the trial, but that's now up for discussion. Also because trials where the genomic test Oncotype was evaluated, Taylor X, and at San Antonio, another trial will be presented, but Taylor X so far showed the same thing, that in women diagnosed under 50 with mid-range Oncotype scores, they also seem to benefit or from chemotherapy, which the hypothesis was they didn't need that. So we think that actually in this younger age group, it needs to be studied whether chemotherapy is the solution or perhaps a more rigorous endocrine treatment would be beneficial. So that's where we were before actually my presentation. And so I'm focusing so far, I focused on the clinical high risk, genomic low risk population. But MINDACT also has over 3,000 patients who are clinical low risk. And so there's much to learn from the clinical low risk population in the MINDACT trial. And the title of my abstract is How Low is Low Risk? So if we look at the survival of the clinical low, genomic low population, so both indicators are low risk, then their 8-year survival is 95%. So that's a really good outcome. And so clearly, if the indicators are low risk for clinical, pathological, and genomic, then endocrine treatment on its own is sufficient for these patients if they are hormone receptor positive. So that was almost 3,000 patients, was 2,744. There were also almost 600 patients who were clinical low risk, but genomic high risk. So there the question was, so they're discordant in their risk assessment, and in the trial they were randomized to yes or no chemotherapy based on either following the clinical or the genomic setting. So the question there is, does the genomic risk actually indicate that is a group that should receive chemotherapy even though the clinical characteristics are low risk? So as a total group, they have an 8-year survival of 91%. So that's still relatively good. And almost all were hormone receptor positive in this clinical group. So almost all received endocrine treatment. So what we then showed that indeed, if you are, or what I just said, if you are clinical low but genomic high, then your survival is a few percentage points lower than if you are both clinical low and genomic low. So the question, if you now compare the two survivals with and without chemotherapy in a Kaplan-Meier, there is a 2.6% 1.5% difference at 8 years, which is an improvement, but maybe also not enough to actually start giving chemotherapy. However, this group is like very, very small, and we cannot formally exclude that actually it would have given a benefit, but we need other studies and more data to prove that. We actually looked into the age separation for this clinical low, genomic high group as well. And then again, we see that actually those patients that are diagnosed under age 50, if we compare the randomization between chemo and no chemo, then the chemo again gives a higher benefit in the under age 50 group than compared to the over age 50. So clearly there are several questions for the under age 50 group that needs to be answered. Maybe with the clinical low, genomic high, indeed chemotherapy would be additive. But that remains, we have some other studies going on to actually further explore that.